2014, probably a lot of tech fans.
Oh, it was a blast. I mean, the kids got better out there. You know, that's a great training tool. When you make it a game for these kids, you make it a game for these youth, it really opens up their wrestling. You know, it's not like, oh, I got to go to wrestling practice. It's like, oh, I get to go to wrestling practice. What you want.
Making kids have fun, developing footwork, fitness, all that stuff. Rate it on your level of importance. How important is it to you?
It's a 10. I mean, it's a 10. Especially if you want your kids to have longevity in the sport, you want them to continue on, you don't push them away, you don't force them to do things wrong. You make it fun, you make it a game, you show them where to improve, because wrestling is a tough sport. You only have X amount of hours that your body and your mind can take competing hard. That's why if you start at 8, you're done at 18. You start at 14, you're done maybe when you're 24, 25. So the longer we can have the longevity of the sport, the better it is for the kids.
Talking about longevity, you know, you're a world silver medalist, Olympian. You know, we talked about a comeback potentially when I was in Ann Arbor in the fall. It didn't happen at the U.S. Open. It's not going to happen at the team trials this year either, doesn't look like. You know, what's your career path as far as the sport of wrestling and competition?
15, 16. I mean, you know, I went through a big conundrum in life. What do I want to do? What do I do? Wrestling could be done potentially. And creating this youth training system, working on developing base wrestling, geared up with the attack bands, is really, I want to show it. I want to show it off because I can do backflips now. I can do a back handspring, catch myself in a handstand. I've never been able to do this before. And just breaking down the wrestling, I really can't wait to go and try it out. I mean, I feel good. I feel I'm 29. I got more than enough time. And unless I really get, you know, pulled in this way, the UFCs, but that's not gonna happen probably.
No fighting.
No. I want to train those guys. I like that. But wrestling's where my heart is. I want to win an Olympic gold medal. I want to win a world championship. I was right there, and to be right there and that close, to not give it my all. No way. I'm going in. I'm getting it done.
I asked Andy about it, and Andy said, you know, it just wasn't time with the timeline of the shoulder and how the recovering was and how your training was going. Is that part of it? Is the timeline just not right for you?
Yeah, and I need a break. I've wrestled since I was 19 every single summer, every single year. I haven't had a break in 10 years. Here I'm at 29. After 8 years, I had to take a little bit of break to recharge my batteries, see where I wanted to go, see what I wanted to do. And I have my pass in it. I'm going to win a world championship in Las Vegas in 2015. You hear it here. USA is going to win a world championship in 2015 as a team title, that's for sure. And then 2016, we're going to have a ton of momentum going into the Olympic Games. And why wouldn't we bring the Olympic team title home?
What's your favorite part about this event? You've wrestled in it. What's your favorite part of it?
Everything, man. It's in the middle of Times Square. Look at all the people. Look at everyone standing around. Look at this crowd. Everyone wants to see what it is. And everyone knows when they look, they go, oh, that's wrestling. They see this thing. They see the mat. They know what it is. Our sport is here. Our sport is big. We just need more things like this to get it done.
You got anything else for me?
Two more points.
Attack bands, base wrestling, and I'm really excited to hyper-focus to use those things back in my wrestling, and I hope everybody enjoys watching.
Are you a double leg ninja?